The metaverse is creating a buzz everywhere, but what does this new digital world mean for urban planners? Well, to answer that question, what better way but to go and discover the metaverse for myself? So I created my own avatar, donned some cool custom wearables, and set out to explore this world of the metaverse. And this is what I found. In today's video, I want to explore five areas where I think there's this really interesting interaction between urban planning and the metaverse. But before we jump in, here's my quick overview on what the metaverse is. First appearing in the fictional work of Neal Stephenson, the concept of the metaverse has actually been around since the early 1990s, but didn't enter mainstream consciousness until recently. A metaverse is an entirely 3D world where people can come together virtually to explore and interact. All sorts of creative uses of the metaverse are starting to emerge, from online shopping and art exhibitions to concerts and fashion shows. Many say that the metaverse will be the successor to the internet as we know it today. Others are a bit more skeptical. And while there are still many unanswered questions, I think that there is actually real opportunity for urban planning in the metaverse and for the metaverse in urban planning. When people think of urban planning, probably one of the first things that springs to mind is land use zoning. Using cryptocurrency, anyone can purchase land in the metaverse. And once you own this piece of digital land, it becomes your asset, your unique digital asset, also known as an NFT. But unlike the physical environment, where land is regulated by zoning rules and design codes, the metaverse offers a somewhat blank canvas, which allows the landowners to use and develop their land however they want. Unfortunately, this freedom doesn't mean that there aren't land use conflicts or neighbourly disputes. In fact, just like the real world, as the metaverse becomes more populated, the number of land use disputes and conflicts between different neighbours are actually on the rise. In the physical world, some neighbourhoods are more desirable than others, and this is exactly the same in the metaverse. In most of the major metaverses, desirable land is being snapped up at a higher and higher price, particularly as corporations and investors start to capitalize on the opportunity to own a plot of virtual land. Also, like the real world, there are speculators who buy these virtual land parcels and sit on them in hope that their value will skyrocket. You may be wondering what makes one piece of virtual land more attractive than the other. Well, actually, it's very similar principles that apply in our cities and neighborhoods today. Places close to the main center with good access and a high level of amenity, or in virtual terms, experiences, are generally the most desirable. With its rising popularity, many are starting to see the metaverse as a commercial opportunity, and it's really easy to forget that actually the metaverse started from this vision, this utopian vision to create this decentralized space, this world which was unregulated by organizational structures and formalities. The question here remains for me is, with these increasingly high financial stakes, at what point does the metaverse need to start implementing more structure to help manage all of this digital change? Given the boundless opportunity for creativity and imagination, the metaverse is providing a whole new way of thinking about architecture and the design of our cities. When you first enter a metaverse, you'll probably notice a very familiar game-like aesthetic. After spending some time exploring Decentraland, I noticed that despite the lack of regulation and rules when it comes to zoning and development, landowners are still placing a high value on design and aesthetics. The metaverse is providing a new playground and creating whole new design industries which blend together architecture, digital design, and development. In fact, I was surprised to learn there are metaverse architects who are specialists in designing and developing digital virtual buildings. The metaverse has the potential to revolutionize the way that we access city services and information. Being able to basically teleport into this 3D virtual environment without leaving the comfort of your home presents huge opportunities for urban planners. Replica metaverse cities might be the way of the future, and we're already seeing cities like Shanghai and Seoul leading the way. Building on existing technologies such as augmented reality and digital twins, the city of Seoul is creating a virtual replica of its entire urban area and its services. By the end of 2022, Seoul is hoping to pioneer a contactless communication metaverse. And by 2023, plans to develop a virtual city hall are already in place. All of this is part of their 5-year metaverse master plan. The metaverse could play a transformational role in the way that we engage with communities, and particularly in terms of imagining and reimagining the future of places and plans. We know that the gaming industry has a strong track record for creating immersive experiences that capture and hold people's attention. There's lots we can learn from this, and the metaverse really presents this amazing opportunity to gamify the built environments in a whole new way. This could make it possible for people to walk through whole master plans and experience new development proposals in a virtual 3D experience before they're even constructed. It could also make information more widely accessible and lead to new ways of people sharing feedback and inputting into plan making. So I hope you've enjoyed this exploration of the metaverse and its interaction with urban planning. If you've liked this video and want to see more, don't forget to hit that subscribe button below so you get notified of new content. My conclusions for now are that there are actually a lot more similarities between urban planning and the metaverse than I had initially thought. And yes, it's early days, but I'm excited about the opportunities and the possibilities to reimagine and rethink the way that we plan and shape our built environments using 3D virtual technology.